everybody. This is Tippy.
And this is Joe.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/the barn.
If it's all right, oh, yeah. I want to kick it with you all night, all night. Woo.
Making it.
Great.
How are
y'all?
Doing great. Well, we're here with Wilhelmina. How's it going, guys? We got Tyler, Derek, Ryan.
Yes, ma'am.
And we're missing one, Lane.
Yeah,
correct?
Missing Lane.
Yeah.
He's always late a little bit. So.
Yeah. Well, tell us your role in the band, each of you, please.
I carry the bags.
That's it? That's all you do?
That's all I do. I try to sing a little bit. Go ahead and tell your role.
I play drums.
I play bass.
Yeah, and I share like a guitar with Lane and stuff. Yeah. So
nice. Your lead vocalist.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Being humble over there.
I just carry the bags.
That is too funny. So you guys have been doing this for about a year now? Year and a half?
Year and a half, yep.
Right on.
Yeah.
How's it going so far? What do you think?
It's been fun, I think.
You think?
As far as I go, I think it's been fun. I mean, I don't know how you guys feel about everything, but getting to do a lot more stuff has been really cool. Like,
yeah.
This stuff right here has been awesome.
Yep, we've been enjoying it. We primarily started out around our hometown, but getting to reach out and go different places and come here today and then play in Farmington later is going to be a good time.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. awesome. And where's hometown?
Hometown is Kennett, Missouri, the Boot Hill of Missouri.
Nice, very nice. So I've got some questions for you guys. Do you want some of these? Okay. So first off, you guys have known each other for a long time, and I know this because I talked to you out at the barn whenever you guys played out there to do your live barn session, and that was super cool. So how long have you guys been together? A year and a half, right? And what's that like, the dynamic of knowing each other for as long as you guys have and being a band together?
It made everything, to me, I think it made everything easy at first. But it's also hard when you want to tell your friend, like, hey, this is a job, too.
Yeah.
So we're kind of, like, trying to navigate, like, hey, this is a job.
Yeah.
But we want to keep it fun. And also, at the end of the day, our friendship definitely matters more than all this. And it's been easy, don't get me wrong. But it's just kind of trying to navigate everything, I think, has been the most challenging part.
Yeah, I mean, we'll go in there and butt heads and fight and argue until we're red in the face. And then... next day, you know, we get together again and we're having a good time.
Then be hugging and kissing.
Aww. Just being all... ain't that sweet? You guys are so nice. So you guys have released two official music videos so far?
Two? Yeah.
Deuteronomy and Leah's song, right?
Leah's song, yep.
Nice.
Yep.
That's very awesome. What's your creative process behind music videos? How do you guys come up with what you want the vision to be?
Really, I mean, we just get together and drink and be like, we think this would be really cool if we did this with this song.
And a lot of brainstorming and, you know, just honestly, like, even the other day, we were talking about a video and just kind of throwing out ideas of like, oh, you know, we're going to hang out here. And, well, what if we do this in the background? And, oh, I like that idea, you know, and so just kind of keeps it rolling. For we know we have probably too many ideas more, you know, than actual substance to it.
Same director for both?
No. The Leah song video, the lady that did our mine and my wife's wedding video, she threw all that together, and it was actually our wedding video. And we asked her, like, you care if we use that for her song? And she's like, not at all. Go ahead and do that.
That's awesome.
And then Chris, what's his last name? I want to give him a shout out. Bartmus. Chris Bartmus. He did the video for Deuteronomy, and he did a awesome job, I think. He came out, and we went down close to Wilhelmina, where we'd always go fishing and stuff like that. And this kid was down for everything. He was outside. We were driving down the road, and this kid is hanging out the window going, we're probably going like 25, 30, but he was outside the window with a camera just recording everything. So fun. Great dude.
Really
so
got into
if you
it.
Get, if anybody sees this and wants a video, hit up Chris Martinus and Brittany Kovac. They're really great people.
Nice, they got social media. Shout out.
I don't even know ours. You know this. I don't even remember ours. I can't remember theirs. There's no way. There's
that is
no
hilarious.
Way.
So, in recording a music video, did you guys encounter any like challenges? Anything that stuck out with you guys that was like, man, that was a hurdle we had to overcome for sure?
I think the timing of it, because we did it the day of a show.
Oh, dang.
And so we were out there in the middle of summer just getting sunburned, sweating.
Yeah.
And then by the time we finally got done, we had to unload, sound check, grab a bite to eat, and then get on stage. So.
Dang, putting in the work, huh? Yeah.
And then in our small town of Campbell, like, we're doing a shot of him at the gas station. And it's really weird when someone's outside videotaping a dude standing by the gas pump. And
I'm sure.
And trying to explain, trying to explain that to them. We're shooting a video. Yeah.
But, did you have people, like, trying to, like, cameo in your video? Like, we do. Can I be in it?
You can't see them, but the women that were inside running the register and stuff, they're just sneaking their heads up. And, like,
that's too funny.
It was hilarious.
We'll have to watch video real close and see if we can see anybody waving in the background or anything.
Yeah.
Hey, what's a bedtime beer?
Oh. It's supposed to be the last beer of the night, but it never is. It never is. I think that's all I can say about it that I remember. Did you give her that?
No.
We're going to talk after this.
That's too funny. So you guys have grown up together, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah. So tell me a little bit about the history way back when. How'd you guys all meet each other? Live in the same town?
It's all 5 miles apart from each other. I mean, me and him and him and... Well, actually, all four of us here all went to school at Holcomb and graduated from Holcomb. Lane and Austin went to school at Kennett, and Derek had actually went to school with them. So, I mean, it's just a small community, and everybody kind of knows everybody. And then I don't think we all really got to hanging out. Like, I don't think I came a part of it until I graduated high school and started hanging out at the place we called Trap. And all we do is watch wrestling and drink and rap songs together and just hang out. I mean, and it's just
kind of rap songs. You gonna freestyle for us today?
I could, but I can't. I made a promise to people I will not freestyle anymore.
Promise. So this must be an issue. The real problem.
Yeah.
So you, speaking of wrestling, I hear there might be a tell there that you guys might have been another activity before you formed the band.
Yeah. We tried a bunch of different stuff. we didn't know what we wanted to be. So we went through, all four of us and Austin went through wrestling training.
It had to be fun.
It was fun. We had gear. We had it all.
We got the shit beat out of us
all the time.
Yeah.
We'd go home and then, like, the call the next day would always be so funny because everybody just hurt so bad the next day. And call like, we can't wait to do it again. But deep down, you wanted to quit. It was awful.
How did you guys get into that?
Oh, we would just talk each other up. We watched wrestling all the time, and we actually had a ring in our backyard, or in that trap.
Like
a homemade ring.
It was a trampoline that broke down, and we end up... So one day, we go and grab some mattresses and stuff, and we had to get some boards, and we're in my Jeep, and I think it was me. Was it us three?
Yeah.
We had to go pick up some woods from this place called Barton's in town. And the Jeep door wasn't closed. So we had little Tyler sit back there and he's holding the boards up and stuff. Yeah. And it was
like, and I'm tall enough to where, like, I'm kind of seeing the road underneath me. We're just talking about, like, man, I just hope we don't get pulled over at this point. This is going to be a bad deal.
Weird.
But. You know,
that's did you think times. He was gonna fall? That's some scary stuff. Yeah. Man. I'd be like, I'm good, I'll hop back in the front.
Every like, volunteer. I swear he went through a parking lot full of just like the speed bumps, you know, like
on purpose.
I'm convinced he pulled off just to find one, you know. It was awful.
That is great. You guys have been camping in Grandin, Missouri.
Yes,
tell me about that.
I wish Lane was here to tell about that. Yeah. It's his spot. It's his stepdad's spot. We used to go up there and camp out over the weekend and stuff. And
is that like a bonding session for you guys going camping out there on his land?
Yeah. We had a lot of good times out there. We recently just lost the stepdad, Tim Jones.
Sorry for your loss.
Thank you. He was a really good guy. But, there was a lot of good times out there. We'd go on the funniest story. We go out there one night, and he's like, Tim was, he was a crazy dude. He was wild, man. He was so fun to be around. But he comes over and he tells me, he pulls me aside and he goes, Tyler, in the middle of the night, you're going to hear one shot. He said, don't be scared. It's just going to be one. I said, okay, Tim. Well, I'm holding this in, and all the other guys are like just hanging around. And we're sitting by the campfire later that night, and Tim had left, and I said, did Tim say anything about a shot to you? He said, yeah, he pulled me over to the side, too. Oh. So he had told us all this big secret. Like, we just, it was just so funny. And I'm going to miss that dude. He was a good guy.
Did you hear the shot, though?
I don't remember it. I don't.
Hey, guys, it's Tippy here from the Tippy Jo Show, and I want to talk about mental health. You guys know that we are huge mental health advocates, and we are all about getting the help that you need. And one great way to do that is with BetterHelp.com. BetterHelp.com is the world's largest therapy network, and it is 100% online. And with over 30,000 licensed and experienced professionals, there is definitely somebody there that is going to suit your needs. It's so easy to get started. You just answer a couple of questions about your therapy needs, and they'll match you with a therapist that's right for you. But if for whatever reason that therapist isn't a good fit for you, you can switch to a new therapist, no problem. And BetterHelp makes it super easy to communicate with your therapist. You can text, you can call, you can video chat. Whatever feels right to you, they're there waiting to listen. And the best part is you can get 10% off your first month's service by going to betterhelp.com/thebarn. That's betterhelp.com/thebarn. Bye.
Looking to cultivate your own cannabis? Visit Main Street Grow Supply, your local one-stop shop for all things cultivation and more. Located at 101 West Main Street in Park Hills, Missouri, Main Street Grow Supply offers a wide range of top-quality products and expert advice to help you grow your best crop yet. Whether you're a seasoned grower or just starting out, their knowledgeable staff is there to guide you every step of the way. From premium soils to state-of-the-art grow lights, Main Street Grow Supply has everything you need to nurture your plants from seed to harvest. So why wait? Visit Main Street Grow Supply today at 101 West Main Street in Park Hills, Missouri, and let them help you grow with confidence. Main Street Grow Supply, cultivating community one plant at a time.
I've heard you guys got a favorite alcoholic drink. What is it?
The goat.
The money in the pocket.
The goat. The goat. We are looking for sponsorship.
Absolutely.
Trying to get sponsored.
What kind of trouble that gets you into, huh? You all drink responsibly.
Yeah.
Send to sleep by 8:30.
Anymore, I'm in bed by 9. So we had a show the other night at the camp, and by 9 o'clock, I had too many honey shots, and I went to bed at our camp, and they come in there and they bring in some pizza, and I really wanted to see the last act. I said, please wake me up. They brought that pizza in. I came back to life, went out there and partied more. And we was out there listening to this metal band. What's the name of their band? Give them a shout out. Dead Birds Can Fly. They put on a hell of a show. It was awesome. It was awesome.
That is super awesome. So the name Wilhelmina. It's a place, right?
Yep.
Tell us a little bit about that, how you decided on Wilhelmina and what it means to you guys.
Wilhelmina is where when me and Lane first got together and he was teaching me how to play guitar, we'd go out there and just fish and do whatever. And when Derek came into the group, we were like, we got to get a name because now we're a band. We're not just Lewis and Gossett anymore. We're like a three-piece now. So we thought, like, we used to always kayak out there. So we're like, Wilhelmina Paddles. And I was like, no, the paddles just seems like a mouthful, so we'll stick with Wilhelmina. And at first I was really worried about it because I didn't realize, like, a lot of people don't know how to pronounce that word. They read and they go Wilhelmina.
Mm-hmm.
it's all kinds of stuff. But
last weekend we got billed as the Wilhelminas.
The Wilhelminas.
Oh, yes. No. Yeah. Gave you an S on the end too. Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, that's the worst. So, Tyler, I heard you had something special in your pocket on your wedding day as a handkerchief. Tell me what you used. Listen, I'm not making these questions up. These came from somebody special.
Yeah. A napkin. the night before my wedding, me and Austin partied a little bit, and we didn't take a shower. We couldn't make it to the venue in time, so we had to take a shower there.
Yeah.
And everybody's throwing these, so I got all the guys' bathrobes for like the wedding, the grooms, you know.
Yeah.
And we ended up having to use them as towels because nobody could take a shower.
Oh my gosh.
And I lost my little pocket square, and Austin folded up a paper towel, and my wife never noticed it until I finally fessed up. I was like, look, it was toilet paper.
Hey, resourceful though, you know what I mean? Yeah, like, that's some MacGyver type stuff. That's good.
That's what you want in a best man, for
Absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely. For sure. He's my get stuff done for you. Oh, I guess I'm here. Hey, Derek, why do people refer to you as gumbo?
I mean, the short answer is just because mud ain't sticky enough.
So. What's the long answer?
Long answer is I was hanging out over at Tyler's mom and stepdad's house, and I was just playing My Name is Mud.
Yeah.
And
great song, by the way.
Yeah, he started calling... Started calling me Mud, wasn't it?
Yeah, he started in Mud, and he's like, no. You're gumbo because mud ain't thick enough. I was like, oh yeah, well, you're sticking with that.
Yeah, we just kind of ran with it.
That's a good one. So does everybody have little nicknames within the band?
Yeah.
Not too many.
Asshole.
Yeah.
Just Ryan, Tyler, Gumbo, and they used to call me T-Lou when I was a kid.
His name to me is T-Lou. It's just Tyler Lewis because I've always called him that. So if I call him Tyler, it feels weird.
Ryan. Hey, you own a barber shop, yeah?
Yeah, I do.
That's very cool. I own a barber shop. Oh. It's not a barber shop anymore, obviously, but this building used to actually be a barber shop. Before I had owned it, somebody else did, and that's what they have in here. What's it like owning a barber shop and it being your main space for practice?
It's pretty cool. Yeah. I've been a barber for 5 years now, but worked for myself for about 2 years. And he actually just started working with me about a month ago.
Yep.
So he rents a chair for me there at the shop and cuts hair now. But we just have like, it's a pretty big shop. Everybody that comes in is like, this place is massive. Why is it only you two in here? And we just don't need any more people.
Yeah.
But the back space is about just as big as the front room, so we have plenty of space to practice.
Nice. And that's really
that
cool.
kind of stuff. But
cool to have your own little space you can kind of just do whatever you want with. That's awesome.
Definitely.
Good acoustics in there?
Not really.
Yeah.
But AC.
It's got AC.
Good AC. We used to practice in my shed.
Yeah.
It would burn you
mosquitoes.
Up. Oh, yeah. It was miserable. Miserable.
Now you've got a song titled The Shed. An album? A song?
Yeah.
And I'm assuming that's where that name came from, huh?
Yeah, well, the picture that we use as a cover art, that is my rinky dink shed.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
It's like a play on Chris Stapleton's
From a Room.
Okay.
So we were from a shed.
Yes, from a shed. I love that. Hey, Tyler.
Hello.
Other Tyler. So when abouts did you join the band and how did that come about?
Yeah, so I could probably go on about it, but long story short, so me and Ryan had moved sort of like Springfield for a few years. He moved back and then I just kind of stuck around a little while, you know, was working and had my own place. And so I just kind of stuck it out. And then kind of around Christmas time realized, you know, I was pretty ready to come home. And so, of course, like, you know, first couple of times seeing them coming home, it's like, you know, we've kind of been waiting for you to like join. And of course, like it was in the back of my mind of like, okay, if I move home, I can join the band and, you know, and then like, you know, potentially get to work with him again. And so, but yeah. And so right about Christmas kind of when I came back and just kind of, I think it was that first week after I moved back, I was like pretty much full time. So here we go.
Yeah. So who's most responsible for like writing your songs? Is it like a team effort or?
Here recently, I feel like it's been more of a team effort.
Mm-hmm.
I think everything that we've put out so far has mostly been stuff that I've wrote. And then, you know, it's either they start off with the instruments on it and then I come in and just put lyrics to it. But here recently, it's been a lot more collaborative. And I think it's getting to be where we're finally finding sound that I'm thinking like, oh, this is a unit thing.
Yeah.
Instead of just starting off acoustically and then we're trying to make it work as a full band song. But no, I think that this new stuff we're doing, I can't wait for people to hear. We got some of our mixes back the other day and I was kind of worried about them, but they sound really, really good and I'm very excited.
We're excited for that too. I'm stoked to hear the full album of that. Yeah. When can we expect that to be released?
Right now it's still up in the air. We still got to hear the final mixes on them, get them mastered. I'm hoping summertime, like summertime, but we'll see.
Yeah.
It's all up in the air right now. So.
Yeah, and I mean technology. There's always something, you know. we know how that goes. Yeah. You always think something's on the right track, and you're like, all right, here's the date. And then the universe is like, nope, sure isn't. Well, dang, I guess that's not the date.
And usually sometimes that works out the best. Like what you think in your head is like, I really want this to happen then.
Yeah.
It works. Sometimes it just works out for the best.
Oh, for sure.
Put it off. So.
Yeah, you got to trust the process and understand the universe provides. It'll happen when it's supposed to happen. That is for sure. Yeah.
Scary though.
Oh, definitely.
Scary.
Always scary. So, who does this full time? Any of you?
No, that's what we're. I think we're all trying to work for it so we can all do this full time.
Yeah.
We don't do any other. I mean, none of us have any other projects outside of like this project.
Yeah.
We all work a second job and do what we can, but I don't think right now. I don't see it happening where we try to. I know I don't want any more on my plate to go do other stuff.
Yeah.
So
I like how you said a second job. Like this is the first job.
Oh, this is this
top
is,
priority.
Yeah, this
I
is
like
numero
that.
Four. Yeah, numero uno. Yeah,
100%. Absolutely. So when you're not doing cool stuff in the daytime, what are you moonlighting as? What's your second job?
I work at a restoration shop. We sell like PPG paints and stuff like that.
Oh, cool.
And they just let me be the counter boy and take off when I need to. So
nice.
It's worked out
convenient,
great.
Convenient, yeah.
Yeah.
And then of course you own your own business. You're a barber and Tyler, you do that with him as well.
Yep.
Okay, and what do you do, Derek?
I work for a mental health company.
Nice.
I just kind of work with families and children that have mental health disorders and you know, help them with access to resources and things.
That's awesome. We're really big on mental health here and taking care of your own stuff. So I respect that. That's really cool.
Thank you.
Hey, you guys played out at the barn for a live performance. And I know that because I was there hanging out for a little bit. What was that experience like for you guys?
I had a blast. I don't know about you guys, but I had a great time.
Yeah, I really liked the setting. You know, it kind of honestly felt a lot like us just hanging out, jamming, and you know, like I know I was telling them, it kind of almost flew by too quick. You know, to where it's, I don't know, could have hung around a couple hours longer.
The barn has that effect.
Yeah. Well, and still now, I'll look at like the video and I'll see stuff in the background that's on the wall, and I'm like, man, I didn't even notice that.
It's like a seek and find.
Yeah. So it was really cool.
That's my favorite like style of like anything is just collectiveness. You know. Because I like playing that seek and find game. Like, what you got over there?
I wish that Chad guy wasn't such a jerk, though. You
know he's
I mean?
A real piece of shit. Oh, hey, Chad, how's it going?
I thought you were still out. I'm sorry. No, y'all, it was awesome. We had a great time.
It is a pretty cool place out there.
Oh, sweet. All the wrestling stuff. We were like kids in a candy store.
Oh, I'm sure.
Hey,
did that bring
awesome.
Back a bunch of memories for you?
I was close
my
to
back
walking
was hurting.
Off of those.
Just seeing it.
Just seeing it.
I was close to walking off of those Pantera cornhole boards.
Oh, I think you might have had a fight on your hands if you'd done that. So I know you guys are going to be performing out today at Big River Outdoor Campgrounds, which is super awesome. By the way, we're living in the future, but this is in the past now. That would be June 15th is when that happened at a Big River Outdoors Campground. What else can we expect from you guys on the horizon for Wilhelmina?
The album coming out. We're really looking forward to that. Hopefully branching out, trying to do some other shows outside of our home base, which we'll be back, people. If you're seeing this at home, we will be back, I promise. Trying to get this album pushed. That's the biggest thing right now. I'm really excited for it to come out. So
I think we got a couple potential shows in the future.
And maybe a music video in the works.
Yeah, I think so.
Coming out soon.
Yeah.
So.
Which, what's the title of the song, or can we know?
I think we're trying to figure between a couple. Yeah. I think we'd like to realistically do a few of them, but, you know, the hardest thing is figuring out which one do we want to do first, you know, so.
Yeah. Of course, you got to take it one step at a time.
That's a good way to look at it. Which one do you want to do first?
Yeah.
Picking that first one.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I think that's like the most important thing for anybody who's reaching for something is never think small, always think big. Yeah. This is the first, not the only.
Absolutely.
Are you guys big on like manifesting your happiness?
Yeah. I know within, like, even the other day we were kind of talking about, like, you know, just saying it out loud and kind of acknowledging, like, hey, you know, we could be at this point if we just kind of keep working the way we're working. And, you know, and so I think to a degree, you know, we manifest it, but, you know.
We've been dreamers forever. Yeah. I mean, since the wrestling days, we thought we was going to be Ric Flair back then. Now we think we're going to be the next, you know. Whoever.
Yeah. You manifest that, but you work your ass off too.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, we definitely understand we have to work hard to do it, you know, and we want to kind of put the work in to get it, so.
Yeah. What's the big, big dream? Like, dreams are endless, of course. You can dream anything you want to dream. If you had it your way, where would Wilhelmina end up? We'll say 40 years from now. So you got time to build.
Yeah.
What's happening?
I think I just want to make a living touring with the boys. That's really all I want to do.
Yeah. On a realistic level, definitely just, you know, enjoying like playing music with my friends and making money doing it. Yeah. But, you know, I think we all kind of want to live a rock and roll fantasy every once in a while too. So.
Yeah, I got a personal dream to play the Grand Ole Opry just dressed to the nines.
Hey, that's a good dream, though, and I hope somebody hears this, and I hope they're like, actually, hell yeah, we'll do that. Yeah. That would be super cool for you guys. Ooh, aw, man, Lane's not here, though, and I've got a special question for Lane.
Well, we can answer.
Well, at the beginning of your music video, Deuteronomy, Lane is wearing a crop top.
I was hoping this
Hawaii. Nothing wrong with men wearing a crop top. I just want to know why.
So, okay. Do you have the picture? Can we show her the picture?
Yeah, I think we got it.
So, we were drinking and one night and just talking shit. We had a show like the next day or the next week.
Yeah.
And I bet Lane that he wouldn't wear this crop top on the stage at the show. And he was like all gung ho for it. He was wearing it, you know, like being all ready to go. And
whose crop top was it?
Jaden's. His girlfriend.
Okay.
So the night before, he's like, what if I think we just conceded, like, if you wear it for this part of the video, I think it's not going to be good for us either if you're wearing this crop top on stage the whole time, so just wear it during the video and we'll call it even. And sure enough, he did.
That's a good sport though. Yeah, man, that's hilarious.
It's funny, I love this about the video. So where that scene where he starts it, there's a Jameson bottle laying by him. And for some reason, I don't know if it's just because I'm not a cleanly person or whatever, but I had that Jameson bottle from the first time me and him had ever recorded us playing music together. So I was like, we got to put this bottle by you. So it was pretty sweet. I thought that was really cool. And was it you that called him? I think that was the funniest part of the video. When you called him, whenever he's laying there in his crop top.
Oh, yeah.
And he wakes up.
Yeah, it's under 2 weeks.
Yeah. But it is funny because even right here, we have a full contract because we make sure that there's like no gray areas in the contract. So we're just reading it word for word, making sure
there's no loopholes. For this crop top. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious.
I forgot all about that.
You can't get a notary for your crop top contract.
That's pretty funny. Lane's also sneaky. He would have worded it the day of and be like, well, no, I don't have to wear this.
I'd be like, see that right there, fine friend.
Exactly.
So who's your goofiest person in your band?
Lane Gossett.
Who's the diva?
Derek.
Yeah, probably.
I'm just kidding.
Gumbo just kidding. Over there, just being a diva.
Ryan gets salty.
Yeah, he's not here to defend himself. Lane.
Yeah, I think we're all divas at our own times. Sometimes we walk in with a chip on our shoulder and accidentally throw it at the other ones.
Yeah, 100%.
Well, that can happen. But I mean, it's good that you guys have such a relationship that you've known each other for so long. I'm sure that makes like any kind of strife you come up on just go a little bit easier.
Yeah,
100%. Yeah, definitely are able to just kind of let it roll off her back sometimes. Yeah. And also sometimes just kind of look at him being like, what's your deal today? Like that does a lot too, where it's like, all right.
Yeah. I'm sure it's nice to be able to have that relationship, to be able to say something absolutely. Like, what's your problem? And it not break up a band or anything. Woohoo!
We kind of adopt the policy like you don't want to go to bed with your wife when she's angry. We'll argue, but we got to leave a little we gotta leave on a good term. Good. We gotta go. Yeah. All right. We can be mad right now, but let's figure this out before we leave.
Yeah, for sure. That's a good way to go about it, for sure. So where can we find your music on social media, on any other platforms?
At Wilhelmina Music on YouTube, or is it 2009?
I think it's 2019.
Yeah. Oh, you are the best. That's why we have a manager. Yeah. YouTube, Wilhelmina.
Austin's working for that money, honey.
YouTube, Wilhelmina 2019. Facebook, Wilhelmina. TikTok, Wilhelmina Music 2019. IG, Wilhelmina Music 2019. And Twitter, @ Wilhelmina Music.
Heck yes.
Yeah.
Super awesome.
You send me that. I'll pull it out of my pocket.
Well, guys, I definitely appreciate you sitting down with us today and talking about some fun stuff. Do you have anything you want to say before we part ways here today, before you guys get out to Big River?
Stream the music.
Raise hell, praise Dale.
Yeah. Looking forward to an album. Yeah.
R.I.P. Tim Jones.
R.I.P. Tim Jones, for sure.
Absolutely. Thank y'all for having us.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you to the barn. Thank you to Big River Outdoors.
Hey, everybody. This is Tippy.
And this is Joe.
And you're listening to the Tippy Jo Show, sponsored by BetterHelp.com/the barn.